You're a big Barack supporter, right, Senator?
I am. Yes, I am.
Well, name some of his legislative accomplishments. Senator, I want you to name some of Barack Obama's legislative accomplishments tonight, if you can.
Well, what I will talk about is more about what he's offering to the American people.
No, no, what has he accomplished, sir? You say you support him.
Tonight.
Sir, you have to give me his accomplishments. You've supported him for president. You're on national television.
Well,
name his legislative accomplishments, Barack Obama, sir.
Well, I'm not going to be able to name you specific
can you name any?
Items of legislative
can
accomplishment.
Can you name anything he's accomplished as a congressman?
No, I'm not going to be able to do that tonight.
Well, that's a problem, isn't it?
Well, I don't think it is, because I think one of the things that Senator Obama does is he inspires. He's able to lay out a vision.
Chris, am I able to say anything?
He's able to lay out solutions.
Chris, I think that is...
He's able to lay out solutions.
Congresswoman, you have a thought?
I'm sorry.
Absolutely. And I think that's the point that we're making in the Hillary Clinton campaign, that Senator Clinton has a record of accomplishments and solutions based on her experience and time in public office. And she's offering solutions, not just inspiration. Not even the person that's here to speak on behalf of Barack Obama can list his legislative accomplishments. I've worked with Senator Clinton
I want to stop and allow you to have the opportunity to list
the accomplishments, sir.
Well, I appreciate that. One of the things that she does, for example, on health care, she offers that and indicates that she's offering a solution.
No, we're not talking about her
really
accomplishments. You're supposed to be talking about it.
Okay, I'm going to have to cut this off because I've been told to, but Senator, I'm going to give you one more shot. List Barack Obama's accomplishments as a U.S. senator now.
Well, what I'll do is now. I will say this to you. He will offer the ability for the United States to be a leader in the world again. He will put health care back on the front burner, where Americans will have real access to health care and not have questions raised about whether they're going to have their wages garnished or have difficulty in that regard. So I'm proud to be supporting him, and I think in Texas we're going to be able to win.
And I'm proud to be supporting Senator Hillary Rodham Clinton, who has legislative accomplishments all across the world. And I thank you for the opportunity to be here to represent her this evening.
Thank you very much, U.S. Congresswoman Stephanie Tubbs Jones, and State Senator from Texas, Kirk Watson.
In defense of Senator Obama, and also in context, can you name one accomplishment of the United States Senate in the last 7 years?
That's a broader question requiring larger preparation.
Yeah, you don't have an answer to that one either.
But let me say, but you know what, Keith? They should be able to make some points here.
I'm not disagreeing with you on that. In 2 weeks, Chris...
But I'm not here to defend the U.S. Senate. He's here to defend Barack Obama, and he had nothing in his... Well, he had nothing to say. That's a problem.
In 2 weeks, Chris and I will have complete coverage of the primaries in Ohio and Texas, at which point I'm expecting a written reply to my
request. Why do you think they call it hardball?
All right, but this isn't hardball. We're doing the election results.
Well, you know, it's late at night and we have to do some work. We have to vet the guests occasionally, see if they got something to say. Anyway, thank you.
When we return, Nora O'Donnell will pick up our coverage. For Chris, I'm Keith. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Bye.